Hey everybody, Scott Spratzer here, DocSports.com. Wednesday, March 27th, 2019, baseball season 24 hours away. The big dance resumes with the Sweet 16 in 24 hours. We're going to get to all the info and a free play coming up in just a moment. First, a quick note, if you've yet to become a member over at DocSports.com, real cool way to give it a trial run. Click on the link below the video, get set up for a free $60 account. You can use those free 60 bucks on any of my daily packages or anybody else over at DocSports.com. And what a time to do it. Sweet 16, Thursday, Friday. Major League Baseball opening day on Thursday. So jump on board now. If you're not yet a member, not yet giving it a trial run, click on the link below the video. Get set up for that free $60 account. Real quick, a quick recap of what happened on Tuesday. We went 2-1 overall over at DocSports.com with our premium picks. We lost in the NBA 0-1 there. Still on an 11-3 run, up over $2,500 for $100 per unit bettors. I've got a play in the NBA going on Wednesday. It'll be available Wednesday morning, DocSports.com. And again, we look to go to 12-3, 80% with our current NBA run, and have piled up nice, decent profits since January 2nd, going all the way back to the second day of the 2019 calendar year, where we've been doing well in the NBA. Want to also mention that college basketball last night is where we won that, along with the NHL. We had Hampton last night over Charleston Southern, and Hampton came back and got the win, 73-67, laying a point and a half or two. So nice win there. We're on a 71% college basketball winning run right now. Not going to be in action on Wednesday slate with a premium pick over at DocSports.com. I do have a free opinion coming up in college for Wednesday in just a moment. Obviously, we'll be in action on Thursday in college basketball. More on that on Thursday's video, which will be posted about 4 a.m. Eastern time on Thursday morning. But again, more on that for Thursday. But we're going to pass those three games or whatever on Wednesday slate. And again, we're not going to have a premium pick on any one of those games. Last night, Hampton on Tuesday got us the win to continue the run, which was a nice win as they came from behind and got that victory. The other win on the 2-1 slate last night was a nice 4-0 winner with Columbus in the NHL. By the way, we've won five straight in the NHL now. We're going for number six in a row on Wednesday. The NHL play, the NBA play, as we look to go to 6-0 in the NHL, 12-3 in the NBA, will both be released on Wednesday morning, DocSports.com. Baseball, as I mentioned, it starts on Thursday. Yeah, we had those two games in Japan last week, Seattle sweeping the Oakland A's, but everybody else, including Seattle and Oakland, will be playing on Thursday. And we've had this tremendous run to close out last year. 66% of the picks we gave out at DocSports.com in baseball over the final 3 months of the season cashed. 66%. And we made up almost $8,000 for those wagering just $100 per unit on those games over the last 3 months of the season. And we look to pick up right where we left off. We will be in action on Thursday. We've capped the games. There's still some prices that have to be hung, but as far as the pitching matchups and the way we break games down, how certain players do against pitchers and all that good stuff, we know where we're going to go as long as the prices are where we want them. And so far in the couple of spots away from Las Vegas that have hung some numbers, we're pretty happy about the way things are lining up for Thursday. And again, we'll tell you on Thursday morning's video just how many baseball plays we got going for Thursday's opening day. But go check out the package right now, man. 66% last 3 months of the season and up almost $8,000 for $100 per unit bettors. Go grab the package over at DocSports.com. All right, the free play coming up in just a minute. Wanted to update Thursday's Big Dance Sweet 16 plays as far as the betting report. Of course, Purdue's taking on Tennessee, where Tennessee's a point-and-a-half favorite. Public and sharps all over the Tennessee Volunteers. The Vols better stay away from those droughts that they've gone into in each of the last three games, including in the SEC tournament when they got killed by Auburn. Man, that game, both games so far in the Big Dance, all of a sudden they just stopped scoring and let the other teams back in it. Colgate killed them at the start of the second half in round one. Iowa comes back from a 25-point deficit in round two. Now in the Sweet 16, they got to stay away from that because, like that game against Auburn, man, if they have a 5, 6, 7 minute drought where they lose focus, Purdue will get them. But anyway, right now the public and the sharps all over Tennessee. Oregon, Virginia. Virginia laying 8.5. Public and sharps are on the underdog Oregon Ducks in that one so far. This will be an interesting game because we'll see if the Oregon Ducks are actually playing at the level they've looked going back just before the Pac-12 tournament. the other day. They were nip and tuck with Irvine. You got to give the Anteaters credit. Did a great job coming back from a double-digit deficit at halftime, but just didn't have enough ammo to be able to overcome Oregon once they got back in the game. Committed a lot of turnovers from about the 6 or 7 minute point on, and Oregon took advantage as Irvine ran out of steam. Against Virginia, they're getting 8.5 points here. Again, the public and the sharps so far on the Ducks. Florida State taking on Gonzaga. The Zags laying 7.5. Public and sharps on the dog here again on Florida State. And Texas Tech and Michigan ought to be a big defensive battle there with these two teams. Right now, Michigan laying 1.5 to 2, as I'm sure you already know. Public is basically split down the middle on this one, 50-50. The sharps so far, about 60% of the sharp money coming in on Texas Tech. So an update there for Thursday's games. We'll update it again on Thursday morning's video, so check that out. All right, let's get to our free opinion for Wednesday night. We're going to turn to the NIT. We're going to take the points with Colorado. The numbers come down a little bit on Colorado. We agree with the movement. Texas got another home game here. They won their first two NIT games. They're only 14-6, though, straight up in Austin this year. So good, but certainly not unbeatable, not great. They failed to cover either one of those first two NIT wins and will enter Wednesday having dropped 5 in a row against the spread. You know, they're nothing special on the offensive end on their home floor. In fact, if you look at their last 5 games overall, they've made less than 38% of their field goal attempts. The difference in their first two NIT games, both wins, came at the free throw line. In overtime over Xavier, the win over South Dakota State, it was a difference at the free throw line that got them over the hump and got them the win. I don't believe they have the goods against Colorado to win by margin, to win by the spread. And so I'm going to back Colorado here. An opinion on the Buffaloes. Colorado plus 5.5 over Texas, your Wednesday night free pick. All right, listen, if you like these videos, be sure to click on that thumbs up button. Be sure to subscribe. Don't miss the premium picks. Red hot in the NBA, 11-3. We get back in the win column, go to 12-3 on Wednesday. Our NBA pick is available at DocSports.com, along with our NHL. We look to make it 6 straight hockey winners. Both plays available on Wednesday morning, DocSports.com. All right, listen, I'm Scott Spritzer at DocSports.com, and we'll be right back here Thursday morning, 4 a.m. Eastern, 1 a.m. Pacific, a look at the Sweet 16, a look at Major League Baseball. Be sure to come back for that. And let's put Wednesday in the win column. We'll talk to you on Thursday.